Now verse 27, and the kingdom and dominion and the greatness of the kingdom under the whole heaven shall be given to the people of the saints of the Most High, whose kingdom is an everlasting kingdom, and all dominions shall serve and obey him. Now this is a reference to the eternal kingdom, which appears first in its millennial aspect in Revelation 20, and it then opens up into eternity. I get a little weary today of these theologians that for years they rejected prophecy. That is, they just didn't study it. They are beginning to do so now, and they like to find fault with the premillennial interpretation of it. And they say, well, now you can see that the millennium is not accurate, that it's an eternal kingdom. Well, the millennium is just a period of testing, just like this period we are in today. It'll be a period of testing, but it leads and eventuates into the eternal kingdom. That's picky when they start talking like that. Now let me read this here. It says, but when this Antichrist, and I'm beginning to quote a statement of Irenaeus, one of the church fathers, listen to him, but when this Antichrist shall have devastated all things in this world, he will reign for 3 years and 6 months and sit in the temple at Jerusalem. And then the Lord will come from heaven in the clouds in the glory of the Father, sending this man and those who follow him into the lake of fire, but bringing in for the righteous the times of the kingdom, that is, the rest, the hallowed seventh day, and restoring to Abraham the promised inheritance, in which kingdom the Lord declared that many coming from the east and from the west should sit down with Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Now, friends, there are those that try to say today that the early church fathers, they were not premillennial. What do you think this man's talking about here? Again, it's rather wearisome to hear these men attempt to try to dissipate and dissolve the millennium and God's dispensational program for this world by saying the early church fathers. And they try to quote some statement that has no reference to it. Now let me give another quotation, and this is from Philip Schaff. Listen to this. The most striking point in the eschatology of the anti-Nicene age is the prominent chiliasm, or millenarianism. That is the belief of a visible reign of Christ and glory on earth with the risen saints for 1,000 years, before the general resurrection and judgment. It was indeed not the doctrine of the church embodied in any creed or form of devotion, but a widely current opinion of distinguished teachers. May I say to you, you're in good company today if you believe we're going to have a millennium here on this earth. Now, verse 28. Hitherto is the end of the matter. As for me, Daniel, my cogitations much trouble me, and my countenance changed in me, but I kept the matter in my heart. Now you see, Daniel did not divulge to his contemporaries the visions and their contents, since they belonged, you see, to the end time. They were disturbing to Daniel, and they made such an impression upon him as to alter his entire outlook. This is something brand new for him. And the study of prophecy in this day is not, therefore, for the selfish gratification of idle curiosity or vain knowledge. Rather, the careful, prayerful study of prophetic scripture has a transforming effect upon the life. And my friend, if the study of prophecy doesn't change you, then you better study something else. That's the purpose of it. It just makes you argumentative and ugly and want to carry on a debate instead of trying to get out the Word of God, then, my friend, there's something radically wrong, because the purpose of it is that you and I might be transformed by it.